And now we go into our fifth bout of the evening, where we have the Frenchman Commande fighting with the grey shorts against Ricky Fortuna. And there you see them at the weigh-in, both looking very keen for the bout.
Yeah, both looking really fit, ready for it, you know.
Great shape, and there we go, and we get underway. What can you tell us about the fighters, Dave?
Both these fighters fighting at featherweight, which is 145 pounds. We got the Frenchman fighting out of MMA Factory, and we got Ricky Fortuna, which is fighting out of Newport MMA, so he should have the home crowd support here, which you can hear them in the background.
Mm-hmm.
Really up for this one.
And a slow and steady start to the fight. As we say, there's been a lot of first round knockouts, a lot of technical KOs there, and they feel like they're just sussing each other out at the moment.
Yeah, both not willing to commit to anything, you know. Ricky throwing a few bombs at the start, but both missing. Shoots for a takedown there, but yeah, the Frenchman does well. Again, he's shooting for that takedown. He wants it. He's not giving it up.
The strength and balance, though, from Coman to stay on his feet there with the takedown.
He's done well there. He is against the fence here, and yeah, Ricky is still going for that takedown. He's just trying to wrap up both the legs at the moment. He's got both underarms, and yeah, he's lifting him at the moment. Is he going to be able to complete this? So he's going to put a lot of effort into this, yeah, and he does. And he's got top control here. See what he can do.
Oh, into the quick counter there.
It's just too easy for him there, Frenchman. You can hear his trainer in the background screaming at him.
Absolutely barking orders at him.
But he's done well here to reverse the position and have him up against the fence here. But he's got to, in the clinch here, he's got to use some knees here, you know, attack the body at least. And she's doing nicely at the moment. But, you know, well defended by Ricky at the moment.
Also, guys, stay with us this evening. We have another two fights after this. Coming up after this, we have Ottavio Giovalli against John Phillips. And then the main event of the evening, Jordan James, who will be fighting David Round. So some very interesting fights to come.
One, that title fight is going to be a really good one. You don't want to miss that one.
We saw them at the weigh-ins and both look very eager to get in the ring and fight their opponent. There we are, returning to the fight. Both fighters still trying to see who can get control of this fight. Oh,
ooh,
there we are.
That's a nice right hook landed there by the Frenchman. Yeah, he's now starting to dictate the pace of this a bit more. He's just at the moment, Ricky, he's throwing shots, but he's just not, none of them are hitting the Frenchman. He's able to just, with great footwork, just dodge those punches.
He's a very quick fighter, isn't he?
See, again, he's a big swing. He almost telegraphs that right punch. And she's, again, just able to take a couple of steps, good footwork, and move out the way. Yeah, that's a bit better there. A couple of strikes landed, nice little right hook. But as you can see, it's just... it's
swinging and missing.
It's got to be frustrating there. He's just always out of reach. Ooh, nice. Nice little counter there by Coman.
Coman has had a few significant strikes within this fight.
That's the difference at the moment. He seems to be landing, you know. Although he's just in the pocket, moves, counters nicely again. I think he's just struggling with the distance here, Ricky, at the moment. Ricky with a professional record of 4 wins and 3 losses, so I think it's important for him to get a win here today.
We've picked up on it before, but the turnout tonight at the LC2 has been great for the event. The mixed martial arts fight in itself is something that has gained so much popularity in the past few months. Years.
Well, recently this year, it's always been Conor McGregor for the UFC. He's really put the sport to a whole new level here, and as you can see with the crowd here, there more and more people are wanting to see it, and I think, you know, it's a...
it's something, as before there was just a lot of English fighters in the sport, wasn't there? And then Conor McGregor came as the Irishman who's gained all this popularity. Are they paving a way for a Welshman to be next in the limelight?
Well, you know, definitely, you know, we'd hope to see someone in the UFC soon. But yeah, that was a good first round there by both of them.
Yeah, it was an interesting first round, wasn't it, Dave?
You can see here, Ricky shoots for the takedown, and he's really persistent in it. He really, really tries for it, and eventually reaps the rewards. So it's going to be really interesting to see how the judges score this. He did get the takedown, but he did not land many strikes in that round. So yeah, really interested to see how the judges score this one.
Come on, quick to counter. And I'd say that he had quite a few more significant strikes during the fight.
Yeah, you can see there he's hitting the body on the break here. Again, left hook, right hook. Lovely.
That is nice.
Just good combinations there. You know, I thought when he went underneath there, he was going to shoot for a takedown, but he's quite happy to stand on the feet and exchange with him. Again, a nice little right hand there at the end. Interesting first round. Looking forward to this one. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, straight into round two.
I think Ricky here, he's got to feign a little bit more. He's got to, you know, at the moment he seems to be just loading up on shots. And yeah, it's telegraphed, so it's quite easy for the Frenchman to just duck up and counter them.
It seems like with the pace that the fighter's got, he's, as you say, he is telegraphing them and not causing any problems.
See that? You know, again, just loads up on that right hand, and it's just easy for the Frenchman to duck under and counter. There we go. Oh, nice combination there. This is the first fight tonight that hasn't been a first round knockout, but it's still an entertaining fight nonetheless. Just hoping here for the Welshman to maybe he's just, you know, land a little bit more, get some of those strikes, or even shoot for another takedown. It was successful for him in the first round, so something like that. He needs to change it up, I think. You know, I don't know what his ground game is going to be like, because the Frenchman got up quite easy from the first takedown, so he's got to try something different here, though, Ricky.
Yeah, this one's sort of making to go all the way, I think.
Nice little leg kick there.
Still in the early part of this second round, there's... they are still seem to be sussing out their opponents here.
Both reluctant, you know, both don't want to get tagged early, and then again, they've seen what's happened tonight, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. I mean, what does that do for as a fighter coming into it, seeing every single fight end in first round? Are you preparing yourself for an aggressive first round?
I think you just stick to your own fight, you know, it's what's happened before. You've got to concentrate on your own fight, but the crowd are. Crowd are going to be used to the first round knockouts. They're going to want more, you know, so they're going to be calling for it, really.
This is
well, there's a nice right hand by Ricky. That's the first one I've seen this round that's actually landed.
As you say, this is what the fans are paying the money for. They want to see these first round knockouts.
Both don't want to engage in any of the grappling at the moment, both happy to stand on the feet and trade. But like I said, at the moment it just seems to be the Frenchman just having the edge at the moment. Ricky's got a little bit more time as the centre of the octagon control, but he's throwing these punches, and the Frenchman's just able to dodge and counter. He's telegraphing them a bit too much, not feinting at all, just loading up, and he's looking a bit more tired in the second round, and the Frenchman seems to be pulling away here. Again, big overhand right, just able to move and counter. Great footwork by the Frenchman.
There's a big swing again.
Buckled a bit. Again, it's just too easy for the Frenchman at the moment. You can hear his trainer at the moment shouting to him, because I think at the moment Ricky's got a... I don't know if he's almost a little scared of getting knocked and getting caught by the Frenchman, but he's got to have to I think he has to shoot for more takedowns. I think that's where he had the mm-hmm. most success in the first round.
In the middle of the ring, throwing punches like this, come on, Day, looks like he could do this all day.
Oh, it's just interesting to see how the judges scored the first round, because this round at the moment, you know, I think you've got to give it to the Frenchman. He's throwing more, he's landing more. There we got a nice little body shot by Ricky, but he's going to have to do more because he keeps throwing those and they're just too easy to move out of the way from. Another nice little combination there. What do you think though of the championship fight tonight? Yeah, that's an exciting one.
It is. As we saw, we'll be seeing a bit later, we had some pre-fight interviews from them, and as I say, Jordan James looked very keen for the bout. David Round, who is the champion, looked very,
very confident going into that
one. Very confident.
You know, both fighters were happy to, you know, both gave each other some praise, but yeah, that's going to be a really good one, and you can see the crowd here really want that one to be a knockout. I'm open for the same, to be honest. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's always more interesting when there's a belt on the line, you know, there's always the nerves. But yeah, the second round there was, again, more, it's the same, the Frenchman's just, you'll see here, just able to move out the way, and then counter nice to see, right hand, left hand. That's the story of the fight at the moment. It's just, he's not being able to find his reach with Ricky at the moment.
It seems like neither opponent has the means of how to finish their challenge.
Yeah, we're going to have to, in the third round, I think that round you'd rather give it to the Frenchman, and the first one you don't know. So Ricky, he's really got to be looking for a finish here. I think his best hope is the takedown and look for a submission.
A few significant body shots there from Command. And here we go into round three. And we were right, it's going all the way after all the first round knockouts.
So we do need Ricky here, he needs something. He needs to come out wanting this.
So you think from the first two rounds that Command is...
I'm definitely going to give the second to the Frenchman. The first one's up for grabs just because Ricky did get the takedown successfully. But even in the first round, the Common definitely had more significant strikes, and he was looking like, you know, he might even be two rounds up at the moment. So if Ricky wants this one, he's going to have to really pull something special out of the bag.
You'd like to see a lot more aggression, a lot more eagerness from the fighters in the last round, wouldn't you?
Yeah, it's been a... I think both fighters are just still feeling each other out, wanting to know, you know, don't want to get caught. They don't want this to be over straight away, you know, because of one silly mistake. So often, you know, this brings a very technical fight. But yeah, and I think the fans here want a knockout. And I think it'd be nice for Ricky with the home sport to you know, give the fans something to shout about and cheer about. But yeah, he's doing a lot better at the start of this third round. But he just needs to feint, needs to go for it. He's got good centre of octagon control, but you know, the Frenchman is just, at the moment, just dancing around him. Good footwork.
Great footwork. You can sense in the crowd that they're waiting for something to happen as well.
Ricky's going to have to pull something out now, you know, It's definitely on him to make this third round his and build up that confidence. It should be there now, you know. He's eaten a few shots from the Frenchman. He's still here. He looks good, but he's definitely, again, just swing and a miss. You know. And it's just a little too easy for the Frenchman at the moment. You know, he's able to see these punches coming, step out the way, move back, and then counter. So. Again, it's the story of the fight, I think. Nice leg kick there by the Frenchman.
As you say, guys, stay tuned with us after this fight as we have two great matches coming ahead. We have Ottavio Giovalli, who will be fighting John Phillips, and then we have Jordan James, who will be fighting David Round in the main event of the evening. And here we are, still in the third round, as Come On Day looks to keep his upper advantage against Ricky Fortuna.
If he gets this one here, if it goes, you know, at the moment it is looking like not one of them's going to knock the other one out, or there's going to be any submissions. I think Ricky here, he was successful with the takedown in the first, and he needed more of that in the second and the third, and he hasn't even shot for a takedown in the last two rounds. So I think at the moment he's being outstroked on the feet by the Frenchman, as you can see there, just easy to move, easy to dodge. There we go, that's a bit better. But again, they're a bit wild, they're a bit...
very wild.
You know, they're telegraphed. He needs to feint, and then jab, and then one of the big bombs behind it. But at the moment, it's just too easy for the Frenchman. If he wins this one, he will take his professional record to 7 wins, 1 loss, which would be, you know, one to watch out for.
You watch when the fighters are throwing the punches. Common Day is just dodging these punches with ease, whereas his opponent seems to be soaking them up.
Although Ricky, you know, he's taken a lot of, you know, strikes, he doesn't seem to be fazed by any of them. You know, there's no damage to him. He seems to be still a lot of energy behind him. But he has tired in the second and the third compared to what he was in the first. But he's still in this fight. He just needs one punch, one of those big bombs to land, and it could be game over. But there we go. That's better. See, need more of that. We needed more of that in the second. Needed more of that. He's holding on to the fence there, the Frenchman, twice. Yeah, he still manages to get the takedown, which is good. But I feel it's coming a little bit too late, you know?
Yeah, I feel like that. Yeah.
This is where he's had his success. The Frenchman here is going to do his best now to get back up, but good top control here from the Welshman.
Both fighters holding on to the fence. It's not something you want to see.
It's just instinct, isn't it? You know, you want to keep yourself up, but yeah, this one's going to have to go to the judge's scorecard, I think.
Both fighters showing the appreciation.
Oh, do you think there, Joe? Who do you think's taking this one?
Well, as you say, at the very end of the fight there, Ricky Fortuna goes for the takedown, but it may just be too little too late there. And Common Day put his arms up there, thinking he knows that he's done enough to win the fight there. But you see in the slow motion replays here, he was landing some punches, dodging all of Ricky Fortuna's.
It was a good fight, you know, it wasn't what we've been used to so far in this fight card, but yeah, it was a more technical fight. But I think the story of the fight there was Ricky, he kept, you know, he should have tried for these, you know, it was successful in the first, third round he had another takedown, but he needed those, he just, the significant strikes weren't there for him, I think. He needed to go for the takedown more, and instead, I think to here the Frenchman might have it, but it will go to the judges' scorecards, and it'll be interesting to see which way they scored this.
Here we go into the result.
Frenchman. He looks really happy with that win.
A unanimous decision there by the judges.
I think it's the right call there. It was a good fight to watch, but unfortunately, you know, he just couldn't land anything, Ricky. And I think that was the story of the fight. He needed to go for those takedowns more. But yeah, really, really enjoyed that one.